Hi, this is Manansal V. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this jittery or wiggly text effect in LumaFusion. This effect uses the ability to apply multiple instances of the same preset that was added in LumaFusion 3.1. Here are some additional variations of the effect. Before we get started, if you like my tutorials, please help me grow this channel. Leave a comment and share your ideas, questions, and suggestions. I will truly appreciate it. We start in LumaFusion with a new project already containing the video that will be used to displace the text and make it jitter. Look for a video simulating TV static noise or fractal noise. For this tutorial, I'm using TV static noise. Make sure that the frame rate of your video is no more than 30 frames per second. Normal TV static flickers too fast for this effect, so let's start by reducing the speed to 25%. On a 30 frames per second video, this creates a stop motion animation that will become part of the effect. Notice the granularity of the dots in the static. If your video has smaller dots, zoom in until you get static that looks similar in granularity to the one in this tutorial. Notice that the video is displaying different shades of gray. Let's transform those shades of gray to either black or white. This will help accentuate the jitteriness of the text that will be introduced in the next steps. Edit the video and under Colors and Effects, add the original preset. Adjust levels, brightness, contrast, saturation, and gamma as shown. Exit back to the timeline. For this tutorial, the length of the effect will be 16 seconds, so trim the video accordingly. Add a title to the project and make it look like this. Use a bold font and text size that covers between a third to half of the screen vertically. Make sure that the face color of the text is set to white. Set the text edge color to white and set the edge width to 3. Make sure that for the font you chose, the letters are not touching. Introduce small spaces between them if they do. Center the text in the middle of the screen. Now, let's give the text a more rounded look. Tap on the Colors and Effects tab, and then select the Styles section. Add the Abstract Edgework style. Keep the radius at its default value of 20. As you can see, the abstract style curves into the text, rounding the edges and widening the gap between the letters. Exit back to the timeline. Adjust the duration of the title to match the duration of the TV static noise video. Duplicate the title and move it to the side. Edit the duplicate title and change the text edge width to 0. Exit back to the timeline. We'll need to use this title again later on, so I'll color tag it in red and call it Solid No Edge. Here's the difference between the two titles. Now, let's show the TV static noise inside the text. Move the original title, the one with the edge width value of 3, above the TV static noise video clip. Edit the title and change the blend mode to Stencil Luma. This is how it looks now. exit back to the timeline. Now, move the title with no edges color tagged in red above the other two clips. This is how it looks so far. As you can see, the title that you just added has a solid white text color that covers the text showing the static. However, because of the difference in edge width between the two titles, there is an edge left that shows the areas affected by the TV static noise. Export your progress and add the exported video back into the project. We'll need this video twice, so I'll color tag it in purple and I'll call it Source Export, so it can be easily identified. Now, let's soften the edges of the text in the Source Export video. Edit the video. Tap on the Colors and Effects tab if not already selected, and then select the Styles section. Add the Abstract Edgework Style preset. The radius is set to 20 by default. The radius controls the amount of jitter that the text will have. You may need to try several values until you find the amount of jitter that you like. For this tutorial, I'll set the radius to 14.50. Notice that the text has some holes in it. We'll be patching those holes shortly. Exit back to the timeline. Add the video that will be used as background to the project. It should be as long as the source export video or longer. Place the source export video above the background clip. As you can see, the abstract preset created a mask where only the text shows through and the black background is masked out. In order to patch the holes in the text, duplicate the title tagged in red. This is the title containing the solid text with no edges that was one of the two titles used to create the original export. Place it above the source export video as shown. As you can see, it covers all the holes. By itself, this is already a nice effect, but let's continue. Let's change the face color of the text to yellow. You'll need to do that for the two clips that now compose the jittery text. Edit the topmost title tagged in red. Tap on the Colors and Effects tab and add the original preset. The original preset will show second in order, right after the abstract style preset that was previously added. Scroll down to the bottom and set tint to yellow. Exit back to the timeline. Now do the same for the source export video clip just below it. This is how it looks now. Next, let's create a black accenture close to the edges of the text. For that purpose, duplicate the source export video tagged in purple. By default, the duplicate will show in the topmost track, which is right where we want it. Edit the new duplicate. Expand the original preset. Change the tint from yellow to black. Collapse the original preset. Now, let's use the ability to apply multiple instances of the same effect, added in LumaFusion 3.1, to add a new instance of the abstract style preset. Make sure that the existing abstract preset is collapsed. Otherwise, you won't be able to add a second instance of it. Move the new abstract preset upwards in order so it shows right after the existing abstract preset. Expand the first abstract preset and change the radius to 6.50. Now expand the second abstract preset and change the radius to 14.50. As you can see, this creates a narrow black edge that is a bit recessed into the text. This is accomplished by the two abstract styles being applied together. This is what each one of them does separately. The order of the presets is also important because presets are applied progressively, with each preset affecting the results of the presets applied before it. See what happens if I switch the order of the abstract presets. Exit back to the timeline. This is how the effect looks now. So this is it for this episode. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to this channel, give it a like, and click on the bell so you're notified when I post new videos. Thank you for watching, stay safe, and I'll see you on the next one.